Hello guys, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay and today in this video I am going to giving a demo on temperature control trainer. In this complete video we will be studying the complete feedback control system of the temperature. Air will be heated inside the temperature oven, and then we will also study the system response, how the system responds according to the feedback controlling of this complete system, and then we will also see the PID controller setting, optimize them according to our features, and then we will also study about the temperature transmitter, analog SSR card and thermostat. I will explain you all the parts of this complete system, then later on we will also perform some experiments, take out some readings and see how the feedback controlling works on this complete trainer board system. This is a complete trainer board for temperature control system trainer with the air. The order code is 52230. You can use this order code to find out all the specification and what you can learn from this complete trainer system by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. Explaining you all the parts one by one, the complete unit is of the two parts. One is the control panel and second one is the heater control and heater chamber, in which we will study the heating of air. Air will be inside the temperature cabinet heated, and there is a fan over here. This is a 1/80 HP motor, and this will circulate the air inside the temperature oven to distribute the temperature evenly. Then there is a temperature sensor. This is a PT100 type RTD, resistance temperature detector, with the sheet diameter of 6 mm and 100 mm long. The input RTD PT100 type and output temperature range is about 0 to 200 degree centigrade that can be sensed with this temperature transmitter. Then we have electronic PID controller. This is a Fuji make model, and the model number is PXF59 with the serial PC interface RTU protocol. RS485 communication is also provided. The input is PT100 temperature input, and output will be given in 4 to 20 milliamperes. And there is display, LCD display of this complete system, in which we will see the process value on the front panel and set value also in the two line display. There are some rocker switches. This is for mains on, this is for PID on, then this is for heater on, and this is for spare. And there are some test terminals also provided on the front panel, on the control panel. This is the input test points, the PID or the RTD output, as for this is for input for PID, is tested on these points. We can test the resistance of this RTD over here, and this is fed to the PID input terminals. The PID input will be testing on this. The output from the RTD will be input for the PID, and output from the PID will be input for the heater control card. So output and 4 to 20 milliampere will be tested on these points. You can test the any of this point using the multimeter, and heater control card input is directly provided to control the heater temperature. The heater chamber side or heater cabinet side, there is the thermostat provided on the safety purpose. You can set the thermostat from 0 to 320 degree, but this is very essential to set the temperature about 180 degree so that the RTD temperature range will not be crossed and you will get the accurate results. Then there are some rockers which also provided, mains on for owning on and off the heater, and heater on is also provided, and fan on. The fan will be circulating the air inside the cabinet so that uniform distribution of heat will be provided. Let us see inside the heater cabinet. You can open this heater cabinet, just unscrew this wall or this handle, and the front door can be easily opened. This is a properly insulated heater cabinet. The dimensions is about 1.25 feet in the depth, 1.25 feet in the height, and 1.25 feet in the width is provided. This is a cubical chamber of the heater control. The heater is installed behind this grill, and the temperature sensor or the RTD is connected over here. This is pressed from the upside, so you can easily take it out and check it. And there is also the thermostat probe is connected with the thermocouple, so that inside temperature will be controlled with the safety purpose using the thermostat. And the pump and the fan is also connected. This is connected directly with the fan over here. The fan motor is connected upsides, and when the motor will run, and it will circulate the air inside the chamber. Let's see the back panel of the control panel. Here, these are the screws. So you can unscrew this and open the panel and see what you can find inside that. So after unscrewing both the bolts, you can use this handle to open the panel. And here, these are the some components inside the panel is provided. Let us discuss about them. So this is the back side of the complete control panel. This is the MCB of 6 ampere. This will provide the complete power supply to the system. Then we have terminal blocks. Terminal blocks are provided for the proper secure connections in the proper manner. So whether you can connect the broker switches, RTD, or you can control the PID connections with their terminal blocks. Terminal blocks are provided for the proper operations, and you can easily diagnose the faults while working with this. So the wiring diagram and the wiring of the complete panel is also got easy using with the terminal blocks. Then we have the heater control card, which is the main component of this complete system, as the output from the PID controller in 4 to 20 milliampere form is provided on this section. This will generate the power output in the voltage form from 0 to 230 volt. So as the voltage across the heater terminal is converted and controlled, the current inside the heater is also controlled, and we can control the power also. So that heat inside the heating chamber will be controlled according to the output of the PID controller with this thyristor control heater control card. So that was the complete description of all the parts and features of this complete trainer board. Now we will start up the system. The complete system works on the 230 volt power supply, and it has a 1 kilowatt of heater inside that, so that we can easily control the heating element inside them. Then we will study and follow the procedure given in the user manual, take out some readings and see how the feedback controlling works. We are ready to do the experiment on the complete trainer system, in which we will follow the procedure as given in the user manual. So procedure, in the procedure, the first step is to switch on the mains on, 24 volt power supply on, PID on, and heater on switch, which are mounted on the control panel. Then switch on the mains on, heater on, and fan on switch, which are mounted on the temperature cabinet. Then keep the thermostat setting about 180 degree centigrade by rotating the knob on it. Enter the PID controller tuning values. P will be entered as a 2, I will be 229, D will be 44.1, or switch on the auto tuning for the better response. Now we will enter the set point as required. We can set 40 degree, 60 degree, 80 degree, 100 degree Celsius, as the PID controller can sense from 0 to 200 degree Celsius. So we will enter the different readings for the proper process. Then we will wait for the temperature to get control and as the given set point. Then we'll use the auto tuning mode for faster control also. So we will study that as well. And then we refer the PID manual, which is provided separately for doing the basic PID setting. And this is clearly mentioned that do not disturb rest of the setting, as it may disturb the process time as well. So we'll do the basic settings of PID, and then we'll do the complete experiment on this. So we'll first turn on the mains on, PID on, and heater on the control panel. So firstly, we will turn on the main switch, PID on switch, heater on switch. All three switches are need to be on. This is the spare switch. So if any of the switch is not working and you got damage through working in your place, you can replace them with the spare switch also. Now we will connect the T1, T2 with the T3, T4, which are the input side. So RTD input will be connected with the PID input, and then output from the PID controller will be connected with the heater control card, so that we can provide the output input inside that. So heater is on from here right now. You can see on the PID controller, the set point is about 40, and the actual room temperature, ambient temperature inside the heater is sensed by RTD and given is 28 degree. Now, after doing all, we will set the PID values in the PID controller. For setting up, all the procedure is given in this user manual. We will also explain it in this video. These are the settings for PI and D, and the rest of the parameters are given for the different channel modes. So we can go to channel and let us set the value in this as described. For this, we will just press the select button for 2 to 3 seconds. Press back again and press select button for 2 to 3 seconds. Here we have now entered in the menu section. Here channel 1 is provided. So when press for entering the channel 1, we will just press the select button. So first parameter is P that we have set over here. So this is 2.7 right now. So we need to change this to 2. So press select over here. And here you can see this is starts blinking. So now it is ready to make changes. So press one up and down key for changing the value. So we need to make it 2. So we have now set this 2 and press select again. So value for P 2 is entered. Now we change the second parameter. For this, navigate to the I value need to be set 229. So we'll set it to 229. So value is set about 229. And now we can set the next value. D need to be set about 44.1. So we'll again change this. You can do the changes like this also. So this is the value that has been done. So these are the factory settings, and this is the settings for the proper response. But if you auto tune the system, you can get your different PID settings as well. These are the PID settings that need to be changed at every time while working, but other settings that we are now going to set will be remains same for all the setups. So hysteresis need to be 0, then BL balance need to be 0, then AR need to be set about 200. So we'll set this to 200. Now the next, reverse action should be in reverse, yes, and set value low will be 0 and set value high will be 200, as our temperature transmitter is has the range from 0 to 200 degrees centigrade. Then TC1 should be 1 and PLC1 should be -1, -5. This is okay, so no need to change. Then PHC1 should be 105, which is okay. Then P cut need to be 0, alpha need to be 40, beta need to be 100. So these are the channel 1 settings. Now we move on to the channel 5, where we need to set the LTP setting. For this, after setting down your setting in the channel 1, just press this back button over here. Now we have again reached the main menu or main window. Again press the select for 2 to 3 seconds. Now navigate directly here from the channels. So we need to change the channel settings. Here LTP need to be 25, so which is already done as the 25. Press select, OK. Press back. Now these are the settings that has been done from the PID, and these are the one time settings. Rest you have to change only the PIND values for the channel 1 for different settings of the PID controller. Now we will move on to the complete procedure, and then let us see how complete feedback controlling works with this temperature system. How the RTD works. The RTD basically a positive temperature coefficient material. It means that the resistance of this material will be changed and increase with the temperature increment. So when the temperature inside the heater cabinet increases, the resistance of the both two terminals, this is a two wire RTD, so the resistance between both the two terminals will be also increasing. PT100 is also called this type of RTD because it is showing the 100 and 100 around the 100 resistance, 100 ohm resistance, when the temperature is ambient, which is 28 degree. So right now if we measure the resistance of this RTD terminal, we will get around 100 ohm or 10 ohm to 102 ohm near about. As we have already set the first set point in the PID controller, now we just need to set the thermostat value near about 180. So here you can see this is starting from 50 degree. So we'll set the thermostat by turning the knob about the 180 degree. So this is near about 180 degree. So we have set the thermostat value near about 180 degree. And this is also mentioned that just open the door about 20% so that air will be circulating properly inside the cabinet, and this will not heat up more than the desired limit. So we'll slightly open the door of the cabinet, and now we'll turn on the mains, heater on and fan on. For the response, I am just giving you the opening. Do not do this for giving and showing the working of fan inside. I am just opening the cabinet to show you in this video. Now while working, we have to close the door about leaving it 20%, and as you can see on the PID controller, the output from the PID controller is now maximum because the temperature inside is need to be increased and there is an error in the set point. The feedback control works likely as when the temperature inside the process value is sensed with the temperature sensor or the RTD for this. This will give you the input to the PID controller, which is sensed by the exactly set value. The measured variable will be set with the set variable and the error signal is generated. The error signal is generated and the output is generated from the PID controller to overcome the error, and this will control the heater output with the SSR card. So similarly, the cycle will repeat and again sense the inside temperature, and then we again see the heater signal inside that and again generate the error signal, and output according to that also generated with the PID controller. Here you can see temperature has quickly risen, and here heater is on from here, but at the cabinet you can see the output is almost zero from the 0% bar graph over here, so that the heater is almost off condition. This is the temperature controlling process, and as you can see and know, the temperature has taken the time for adjusting the atmosphere. So for taking up the reading and taking up the system response, you can take the readings at every 5 minutes of interval and then note down it with the time, and every 5 minutes take the reading and you will find out the graph system response as described in the user. Taking the reading at every 5 minutes, you will find the same graph as described in the user manual. This is for the reference. At the start, your temperature will hit the maximum here and it's increasing continuously, and then again the controlling of the action of the feedback control will decrease the temperature through the set point. This is the set point over here, and for stimulate the temperature it will again go decrease and again go increase, and in some time you will get the proper response. It will take about 20 to 15 minutes for getting the proper response output to reach up the set point. Here in the trainer that we are reading in the system, so 53 is the maximum point that we have get till, and now completely decreasing the temperature, so that now the graph is going lower down, and at every 5 minute if we take reading, we will get the same response as I described in the user manual. So the graph of the system response will be going on. Here you can see the temperature is now going down. It will again reach about the 40 degree, go below than 40 degree, and again increasing up slightly, and then it will not go more higher till the first cycle and the first overshoot, and that's how the feedback controlling works. Here after about 5 minutes of interval, now you can see the reading is going down and heater control action is going on, and 44 degree centigrade is right now the output from the 53 degree, and continuously going down, reaching about the set point, and similarly we will take the some more readings like in this manner. In next 5 minutes and in next 3 to 4 minutes we have now reached about the reading 41. Here I have set the PID controller, just press this back button so that you can observe the system response output is about 10% right now, and depending on the error value this changes accordingly. So for adjusting the temperature inside, the heater and PID controller is continuously changes the output of the heater control card, and now our set point is about to reach. Here we have match up the set point and let us see how down it's go, and again it will again starts hitting the heater inside the temperature cabinet for maintaining it about the set point. If you can able to see the heater on signal on the indicator of this rocker switch, you can see there is a slight currents inside the heater coil, so that it is showing very low intensity of the light of this heater control card, as the output from the heater is very light. But when the temperature goes down and again heater control card gets some higher amount of percentage in output, then the light of the heater control is again light up more than that intensity. Here you can see the temperature is now going 39, so this is slightly lower down the set point, and this time heater output will increase, and as the heater output increase, you will see the lighting up of the heater control card or heater control switch will be also increasing. We have one more lower count, is about 38 degree from the set point, so graph response is going down slightly, and again the heater output is increased. So you can see the heater point is now increasing and the intensity of the heater rocker switch is slightly more. Similarly, if the temperature goes more down, it will again heating up and the current to the heater control card will be increased. So for the next reading, the temperature is slightly increased, which is now 39 degrees Celsius, and continuously heater output is provided with the fixed amount of the heater coil, so that you can increase the temperature inside the heater cabinet with the efficient manner. So that temperature inside the heater cabinet will also set about the set point. So 39, now our graph is again increasing slightly, and let us see how more the set point is we can achieve from this response and how quickly we can get the set point. Now in the next reading, in our next 5 minutes, we have reached the set point, which is 40 right now, and let us see how much increment in the set point happens, whether it happens or not, and if this not happens and it will saturate at near about the 40 or 39, so we can say the feedback response is working quietly efficiently, and we can get the set point and desired set value of the 40 degree centigrade. This is how the system response or the feedback system or feedback controlling of the temperature system going on with the PID control. And now you can change the readings for the next other readings. You can change the set point. For changing the set point, you just need to press this up and down keys. So now we are going to change the next set point. For this, we are going to set the next set point about 60 degree and then press select over here. Now as I press the select, you can see the temperature inside the sensed material is about 40 degree and the set value is 60. So here output from the PID controller is quietly 100%, and over the heater temperature cabinet you can see the output is completely higher, so that the temperature inside the cabinet need to be quickly near about the set point. So it's again increasing the graph as the set point changes. So here you can see the temperature starts increasing and it will quickly achieve the next set point in the system response, as we have from the first set point system response. It will go higher than the set point, then again come down and again come down from the set points, and it will again reach up the set point, and in one or two cycles it will take the saturation and the set point of the 60 degree will be remains constant. You can also observe that as the temperature is increasing, the output from the heater control card is controlling, and now output is about 20% or 30%, so that the heater controlling will be happen in the efficient and accurate manner for the PID controller. This is how feedback control works, and you can get the faster and quicker response with the auto tuning. So now with this set point, we will also see the auto tuning, how we can auto tune the complete PID system and how we can achieve the faster response of this. For setting up the system for auto tuning, you just need to press the select button one time and navigate from up and down key to the AT menu over here. You can see this is now off. Press select, this starts blinking, and now you can change this to on with the navigation key and press select again. So here you can see auto tuning of the system is now started. This will determine the PID control value with the atmosphere and the climate of the surrounding, and the PID value will be changes according to the auto tune setup. It will auto tune the system in some time and again reach back to the main home screen so that the system will be work starting in the auto tune mode. So here in 1 or 2 minutes the system is now auto tuned and now starts working out according to the auto tune settings. Over here we can also observe the PID settings after auto tune setup. The PID settings inside the PID controller that was we entered from the manual as per the setting value or as per the factory setting value, how much the changes inside the PID settings occurs after auto tuning. So for this we'll press select again, channel 1, enter in this. Here P value remains the same as we enter it as 2, and now we see the I value is 229 for this system same, and D is about 44.1. so the complete system has no changes with the auto tune setup and the other settings will remains same. So we just need to change the PID settings for the different responses, so you can see the different working of PID controller with the different PID settings. So here after auto tuning we can observe the system response is quickly much faster than the last one with the manual mode, so that we can get the output according to the same value. Is again going down, and in some time with the lowest point it's again starts increasing and going near about to the set value. Here you can see system senses the temperature is quite lower, so it's starting heating up the chamber. Again heater is provided the higher currents, and in some time the temperature will starts again heating up and increasing. Temperature starts increasing again after 56 degree, which is the lowest reading for this response, and now again increasing continuously, and as the system reaches the set point the output from the PID controller will go completely zero for the setup. Here you can see the output is now going down, output percentage is zero now, and let us see how much increment in the temperature will occur, and then it again starts going down. So 67 degree is the maximum amount of the temperature that is going up, and now it's going down again, and let us see how much time does it take for the stabilizing about the set point. Taking up the readings in every 2 or 3 minutes of interval, make sure you will take the proper reading, and this is a temperature dependent practical, so it takes time for getting up the proper experimental readings, so you need to be very patient for taking up the readings. Now system is going towards the set points, and in some time we will achieve our second set point also. Now we do the complete explanation and experiment in this complete trainer board. After completing your practical, just you need to first close the heater switch so that heater will be in off condition properly. Then turn off the heater over here from also, then turn off all the rest of the things and open the cabinet for cooling down the inside temperature cabinet. So when the temperature is completely cooled down and reached about the atmospheric temperature, then you can move this machine to the any of your safe places. That was the complete demonstration of temperature control trainer with the air is the medium, and I hope you will get the proper understanding about the feedback controlling system of the complete feedback control loop, and you will also get the knowledge about the temperature transmitter, in which RTD is the temperature transmitter that we have used. Also you will get the knowledge about the heater control card, PID controlling and the PID setting that we have done in this complete practical. And you can use the user manual for better understanding about all the parts and all the aspects of this complete system, and you can follow the video as I described and suggested in this video for doing your practicals. And still you find difficulties, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all types of supports. Like this video, the content is useful for you and you get some knowledge about the temperature controlling with the feedback control loop. If you get the knowledge about the temperature transmitter, how the transmitter works, how the RTD works and how the heater control card works, so you can press the like button, and you can also share this video to the colleagues, to the fellows and to your classmates for getting up the knowledge and spreading the knowledge about this type of system as well. Also subscribe our channel, which is Tesca Tech on YouTube. There are a lot of video with this type of experimental explanation and detailed studies are uploaded, so that you can get the information about different type of educational trainers. Don't forget to press the bell button, so whenever we upload our new video, you will get the proper notification about that. So till then, thank you for watching this video, and we will meet in the next video very soon.